Hey, I'm still in the kitchen, but I'm doing something different. The dishes are washing, and I am gonna try to make some pickled jalapenos. But these jalapenos reminded me of our Bible verse yesterday. Now let's practice it. Say it with me, please. Ephesians 4, 25. Therefore, putting away lying, let each one of you speak truth to his neighbor. All right, and you know how we were talking about with lying, how important it is, how God says he cannot stand it. And we talked about how the reason for that may be that it hurts relationships. People can't trust you when you don't tell the truth. Well, that made me think of these jalapenos. You know how Mrs. Gordon would bring different snacks or foods for you to try sometimes if it had something to do with our lesson or maybe we just the theme or season? Well, these jalapenos, I don't know if you know about them, but they are very spicy, very spicy. So I was thinking about that and the lying stuff, and I thought, what if I brought these in one Friday, but I didn't tell you the truth about what they were? What if I said, because some of you had not tried some of the things that I brought in, and I told you about them, or other people in the class told you about them, and some of you were willing to try this stuff, even though you didn't know what it was, because you trusted me or trusted your friends. So what if it was like that, and I brought these in, and I said, oh, these are a fruit, and you didn't know anything about jalapeno peppers, and I didn't say they were peppers, I said they were a fruit. Because they're pretty, they're nice and pretty. And I just said, ooh, they're sweet. They're really sweet. You'll like them. Well, peppers, jalapeno peppers are not sweet. I like them, but they're spicy. And I wouldn't eat one. I wouldn't. Some people might. I would never just eat this because it would burn my mouth. And I don't want my mouth to be burned. But if you pickle them, they taste really good. I think like on Mexican food. I don't think a lot of you would like them. I think you would think they were way too spicy. So, if I were to say, this is a fruit, it's sweet, try it. And you trusted me and you tried it and it burned your mouth and you could not stand it and it was nothing like what I said it was. The next time I brought in something for you to try that you had never heard of, would you try it? Probably not. You would probably say, I don't trust you because you told me before that these were sweet like a fruit. And they weren't. You lied. So I'm not trying it again. See how that happens? Because I didn't tell the truth one time, the next time you didn't trust me. And that's a good thing. I wouldn't trust me either, right? I'm not gonna trust somebody that tells me something is not going to hurt me and then it hurts me, right? So that is a good example, I think, of why God cares so much, why God gives us that rule in His Word over and over again in our memory verse this week. Put it away. Do not lie. Isn't that cool? We're going to see tomorrow in the lesson even more about that. Like I said, we would be seeing. But today, our lesson, so it's in Acts, and it's after we know that Jesus came, we know Jesus died for our sins, we know he rose again, and now he's in heaven, right? We know that, and it says he's preparing a place for those who believe. So, is that all that went on? No, the church had to be started. You know, the church, which is the people that believe in God, where they gather together, that was something that came after Jesus went to heaven. He told Peter, do you remember who Peter was, one of the disciples? He told him to start, that he was going to start the church with Peter. So, Peter and John, another disciple you'll remember, they were going about, as were the other people who believed in Jesus, and telling, because that's what God told them to do. That's what God tells us to do. Tell other people the good news or the gospel, the good news of Jesus. And that's what the church is supposed to do. So they were doing this. Now there was a time that they went, and this man who was on the street and he was begging for money as he did day after day, and he asked them for money. Well, they stopped and they said, we don't have any money to give you. They didn't have any money. We don't have any money to give you, but we can give you this. in the name of Jesus, rise up, stand up, and walk. A miracle, right? Now, Jesus wasn't there to perform that miracle, but Jesus gave them the power to do that miracle. They couldn't have done that on their own. He gave them the power to do that. And he was still using that kind of thing to, Jesus was, to show the people, wow, this is the power of God. So people were coming to believe Jesus because of these things they were seeing. So, and they told them, this is in the power or the name of Jesus that we do this. And they said, Jesus died for you. And so people were becoming Christians. Now, what's a Christian? A Christian is someone who has put their faith, their trust in Jesus. Okay? So the same way then is the same way now that someone becomes a Christian. A Christian is really just someone who follows Christ. Christ is another name for Jesus, right? We know that. So it's someone who follows Jesus, who has trusted. They've said, I'm a sinner. I cannot save myself from my sins, so I'm going to die in my sin unless someone comes to save me. And that someone, and the only one who can do that, is Jesus, right? So that's how people were becoming Christians in the early church. And that's the same way people become Christians now. People like you and me have to tell people, other people, all people, that Jesus saves. All right? And we want to speak the truth to our neighbors. So I'm going to keep doing this. I'm going to wash my hands really good. And I'll pickle them. Maybe I'll show you what they look like after they're pickled.